Hey everyone, really quick, let me know if you like the Madden 24 franchise. If you haven't watched it yet, watch a little bit of this episode, some of the previous episodes, and let me know what you think, because the Madden 24 franchise is on the line. I'm going to have 10 episodes where I'm really figuring out if the series should continue or not. So let me know if you'd like it by hitting the like button, commenting. Those really do help. Now let's get to the episode. Episode 16 starts off with a big point. Look, Jahmyr Gibbs is a top player, player of the week. That is amazing. I mean, he had 34 carries, 266 rushing yards, 7.8 rush average, 2 rushing TDs. He kind of deserves to be one of the players of the week. Now, honestly, we have a breakout on defensive line. And yeah, McNeil looks like he has a chance. Hold the Broncos less than 100 rushing yards or get him one interception, one forced fumble, one tackle for loss or sack. I think that's doable. I think that's doable against a Broncos team. Now, guys, I am going to do the training. We'll be right back. With the training done, we have a couple upgrades. One to our fourth string running back, just because we've had so many injuries I want to carry for, Justice Hill. Now, overall, looking at him, break tackle's kind of low. He has great speed, great acceleration, great agility. I don't know why I had problems seeing acceleration there. But I do feel like his trucking could be boosted. So honestly, I am going to go and boost power back, and plus 4 break tackles. Actually insane. It actually helps him quite a bit. And then Jack Fox, our punter, who accuracy needs to go up. So we'll hit accuracy and hopefully we get something big just to. But that takes it to 77. That is a lot better. I was hoping for something massive, but we take what we get. So guys, making sure I hit play full game. It's us against the Broncos. And I think this could be a tougher match than on paper, like shows, especially with how they're playing IRL. But in Madden, things are always different. We never quite know. I mean, we do need to start winning out these games if we want any chance to compete in the division, to try to get to the playoffs, which is technically still a possibility. Sad enough, it is a possibility. But winning this match is key. We're going to skip. We don't need to watch all this stuff. We need football. So, was that Aiden Hutchinson I just saw? So, yeah, all of them, a lot of our players should be back. Should have gone over an injury report. I'm just too excited to play because of our last game. And hopefully we start off strong here. And hitting him at the 15 is not a bad start. And here comes Danger Rush. I can't say Russ. Oh my god. It's because he's not a Seahawk anymore that I can't pronounce his name. It was, you know, the moment Russell Wilson left to the Broncos, I was unable to pronounce Danger Russ. Rush. I can't even say Russ. Why can't I say Danger Russ? I can say it there. This is not good. This is not going good. I should just shut up and play football. All right. So far, knock away on the first play. And a sack. That is big. That is not who we need to have a sack, though. We need McNeil. Although he could have been involved on that. He could have been involved in that because it was only a half sack. So I'm going to bring Anzalone over here. And incomplete, 4th and 17. Big pressure there. And we are going to get a return. Okay, really quick. I do want to check that player stats. Defense. Okay, so no. Okay. That's all right. That's all right. Just seeing in case I see any, you know, if he was involved with a half sack, because that would at least put him only half a sack away from being involved. So we're going to pick this up on their side of the field. Oh, damn. Big hit. But we have the ball at the 36. This is one of our best starting positions ever. And David Montgomery is back, so we are going to just try to run all over them.
They'll be led out by a man who nearly broke the single season rushing record for quarterbacks last season. A true dual threat out of Ohio
okay. State, Justin Fields. I'm hoping David Montgomery gets us off to a strong start. He is kind of our. Oh, he kind of went backwards there. It's third and second. I mean, do we rush him again? I believe we do. It would suck if we get this great field position and only get a field goal, but we should pick up the first, and we did. Just got to trust the run game and keep going. I need to not let myself doubt, and yeah. And okay, tackled. That's fine. He picks up another first. David Montgomery's off to a great start for us. And yeah, can we pick up a touchdown here? Can we take that lead? I just tried to truck and no trucking happened. I was hoping to try to truck and ooh, nothing. So we're bringing in Jahmyr Gibbs. Maybe we can surprise them. Oh, he kind of got tripped up and slid. All right. Well, it's third and fourth. They want us to throw. Do we trust this? Oh, my God, dude. Fields makes a tackle. I'm just not going to throw again. Fuck it, man. I should have just ran. I should not have trusted. Man. I should have just ran like I thought I should have. I'm doubting myself, and it's fucking gonna fuck this whole shit up. Like.
Just an alright day from him last week. He really didn't break out for the huge yardage he had hoped going in. I talked with him before the game, though. He knows this is a new, fresh opportunity. He's put last week behind him, and his focus, getting some extra yardage with every carry he receives this week. And
Williams, we're going to put some pressure here to see if we can't get that sack.
Up the middle, it's Williams.
Okay, he gained four. That's not great. I'm afraid of Russ throwing the ball. I can say Russ then. I can't say it when I'm trying to say danger Russ. I can say it then. Man, that interception has completely got me fucking frizzled. Like, I'm not making smart decisions.
Well, before we even get to the keys, let's start with the problems he presents, because he feels pressure so well. He's got a great sixth sense, maybe even a seventh and eight.
That sucks. He knows how to slide away from it. Sometimes second and eight. Should have got the sack there, man.
So to me, is that pressure inside? Big tall guy.
Ball start.
To make him try and throw over them and make his height work against him.
Yeah. That helps us. That really does help us quite a bit. Now I just have to capitalize. I have to do something here. Okay, so they pick back up kind of what they lost, or they gained three technically. So we have to stop. Let's see. I don't like. Okay, only gained one there. They're at the 46. They might still be. No, they're going to punt. Okay. Yeah, okay. I'm sticking to my gut on running and throwing on plays where I feel comfortable. I did not feel comfortable in that one, and it blew it up in my face. My own player blocked me. That shit needs to change, dude. Like, get out of my fucking way. That shit's frustrating, man. That shit alone makes me want to stop, like, playing this game, even though... Hello? I got stuck to my player! I literally could not detach from him. What the fuck is that, dude? Okay, just end the first. I'm like... This is frustrating. I don't get that. Why does it stick to my player? Like, because in real life, a running back would put his hand on him to try to use him to push him forward or push him out of the way or do something. He wouldn't just stick to him like a useless idiot. Like, damn. There's a lot they need to fix in this fucking game. And I'm just, yeah, I'm completely fussed. Oh, fuck. I'm just fucking pissed at this point. I literally had no confidence in any of these plays, so let's just go out there and fucking fail. Throwing on third down, Fields. Fuck yeah, I'm not fucking throwing anymore. This is gonna be a loss. I'm like, fuck, I don't feel any confidence in anybody on the goddamn field right now. In the victory last week as he sends this one away. It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return. And the Broncos. And we would have had a first or at least a lot of yardage on that first fucking play where my guy got fucking stuck on his own offensive lineman or blocker. Throwing to start the drive. Wilson. Man, he's got it complete to Cortland Sutton. And what do we do here, man? I have no fucking idea. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down. I truly don't know. Wilson. He actually got that out. So they still get the completion even though the blitz was on. But the blitz got there. Does that stay in the mind of the quarterback for the next couple plays? That's what you're hoping for. That's what you're planning for. It's a little risk-reward, right? You're leaving your guys on an island back there in man cover. Come on, dude. My guy came and fucking attempt to catch a ball. They're able to handle fucking three people hitting him. It's games like these where I just want to trade everybody on my offense besides the offensive line and just invest in it. Damn, dude. I'm torn out of the game. I'm not even fucking like focusing anymore because I'm just so pissed at every little fucking stupid little thing that's fucking ruining this game. And I just completely fucked that up. I had the sack, and I fucking misclicked. So, yeah, this is fucking horrible, man. So, we've lost. I, no faith. I, there's not a single person I fucking trust on my team, so. Yeah, it's 7-0, but all the shit that's gone on, faith, a zero. Hard zero. So, yeah, let's just hurry up, go out there and fucking lose, like. It's fucking pathetic, dude. I legitimately don't even care anymore. Like, what the fuck happens? Let's see if he sticks to somebody again. Like, I don't expect every play to be perfect, but the sticking to offensive... Fantastic. Let's just keep going fucking backwards. I'm just going to run, and when I have to punt, I have to punt. I've pretty much given up. I'm not going to throw the fucking ball. And I literally told him to go outside, and he just didn't. So, I literally was holding the stick this way. You could see him moving that way, and just stopped. Was ready. Yeah, this is a fucking just shit show. Because the quarterback's not having much action where he's getting away from the line of scrimmage. He's catching the football, making a little head fake, and then handing it off. You should be able to read it as they did there. It'll be a 39-yard punt, 4 on the return. Man, this is your fucking fun. Wilson and the Broncos now with a 1st and 10 at the 33-yard line. Throwing to start the drive. Wilson. He's got his 6 points. Yeah, we're just gonna lose this one. And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield. An excellent way to start the drive there. 18 yards. Throwing now, Wilson on 1st down. Anzalone gets a sack. Lions pressure, he's That's not exactly who we want to get the sack, though, but, you know, it's a sack. 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. Now Wilson. Really? I just can't fucking bring anyone down. Everyone on their team is fucking just, like, fucking primetime players. Fucking their tight ends are... Now that was a broken screen, so we'll get the ball back with 2:37 left. Though it does not really matter because I truly don't believe in this team. I don't know why the running is constantly sticking on people, but it is. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. On the return comes Cobb. At least that time no one blocked us as we were trying to cut out. And another player's injured. Of course they are. Because why not? The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. As we eat closer and closer to intermission, Charles, remember last time out there. Nothing's gonna happen. Let's just fucking run this out, man. This is gonna be one boring ass fucking game. Yeah, and this is what close games feel like because the pressure is on both sides, but sometimes the pressure's a little bit higher on the team with the slight edge because they're trying to hold on to that, trying to increase it. Let's see how this one continues. And we're just gonna run. Second down, and they go back to Gibbs. They'll wind up getting 10 back. No huddle. Just gonna run it again. Hurry his guys to the line. Gibbs will try and pick it up. And back, and we're gonna run again. Oh shit, I didn't click run. Damn, dude, we just don't have the speed for anything. Here, Gibbs is quick, but not quick enough, I guess. On second down, here's Gibbs. Okay, we're going to take a timeout here. Yeah, there's no way they're expecting a run here. Another run for Gibbs here. Great job, dude. Don't fucking block anyone, you piece of shit. God damn, dude. You know it's a run play. Fucking block somebody. We're going to have to fucking throw here, and I have no faith in anybody. As they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. This will be play number eight here on the drive. It's third and a yard. Back to throw. Fields being chased out left. And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football. Yeah, no. I have no fucking faith, man. No, we're just going to go for it and they get the ball back. They fucking get the ball back. I'm truly fucking done. Can I rotate out? Maybe. Yes, I can. He'll buy some time right. I don't think I'm going to be able to pick up the touchdown. We have one timeout left. Wow, first and goal, and defensively, all they can do is shake their heads. Not only did they allow the conversion, but a big play as well. I have no one I can really trust here. Jahmyr Gibbs actually gets in. All this time, and we barely score at the end. I mean... not a better time to do it than right at the end, but it's just like... I literally... he's the only one I can trust on my field right now. And Russ still has all three timeouts. No matter how much they'll degrade him, he still has that ability to do what he did in Seattle and throw deep and create magic out of nothing. Because that's still in him. It doesn't show up as often right now, IRL. But this game doesn't know that. He still can be the Russell Wilson that, you know, those Hail Marys that surprise people. Here's Wilson. They'll set up the screen. This is Williams. Okay. And yeah, so they're just gonna try to screen him. Okay. And yeah, that should be it. End of the half, it's 7-7, a boring game, but we're in it. With how bad we've been, I'm amazed we're not down 21-0. maybe to slow the pass rush down a little bit. I'm going to try to protect the run. I think we just have to defend the short pass because that's kind of what they're doing. And we get the ball back, and hopefully we can actually go down the field and create something. Like, there's something about this game and this year and some of the stupid stuff, like sticking on to people and shit, that makes me not feel any confidence that I feel in real-life sports. Like, it's funny. Real-life sports, I'm like, okay, we're down, but we're not out. We can fight. Bend, don't break. Video game football, I'm immediately like, fuck everything in a second. I don't know what it is. Because I'm not like this with other video games. And I'm not like this with real-life football. Like, I can tell when my teams are doing bad. I'll talk shit about my Hawks if they're playing bad when I see them. Just because I know what they can do, what they are doing, and when there's bad play calls. Funny enough, for some reason I can tell bad play calls in real life, but in this game, I cannot read shit. I should have just cut up there. I was too busy fucking ranting and not paying enough attention to football. We may actually, if we can do something here. Oh, he has a spin move, but yeah, not enough blocking. Can we pick this up? Honed in on it and stopped him. Marked that down for a win in the defense. Oh, shit. He'll be tackled about 2 yards shy. The blocking was pathetic on some of those plays. Leads to fourth down. I know they want, you know, I'm going to go for it here. Fans want him to go for it, but listen, I'm going to play head coach right here and look at the facts. Tie game, plus, even if you get the first, you still got a half a field to go. I'll go ahead and punt the football. Okay, we went for it. The announcer, I just wanted to let him talk because he was literally, oh yeah, your fans want you to go for it. I'm a fan. Okay, I'll go for it. He talked me into it, man. I know he was trying to be like, hey, player, don't run it. Be smart. And we pick up another first. There we go. But the whole time he's like, the fans want it. Well, if the fans want it, you kind of have to. I mean, come on, buddy. All right, they keep wanting me to run this jet sweep fake. Oh, it's not a fake. Oh, shit. I thought it was a fake. That's right. Can we get this to the outside? Probably not with how our blocking's been, but... Oh, it's a flag. Don't tell me it's holding, dude. You don't need a fucking hold. I still think they should make holding penalties a lot worse calling. Like, I think it's absolutely fucking stupid. Temporarily out of field goal range now as they come up on a second and long after the holding call. Up the middle they go with Mostert. All right, Mostert picks back up 13. So it's 3rd and 5, and they want us to throw it. Do I want to throw this? I do not think I want to. From the gun on third down, Fields. Mostert catches it. Nice. I honestly thought we had Jahmyr Gibbs in. That's why I ran that play. I didn't even look at the number. I was so certain we had Gibbs in that I was like, oh, Gibbs can run this route and sneak it up on him. And they'd have no idea. And it wasn't Gibbs, but Mostert still caught it. So, you know. And we get Jahmyr Gibbs in, touchdown, we actually take the lead. So, literally throw it to Gibbs, run with the quarterback, or run with Gibbs, or whatever running back we have. That's pretty much the game plan. Don't throw it to anybody else. So, all right, now we need to stop them on defense, get the ball back, and try to create a lead. Every week, I tell myself to just run. And the moment I get in here, I'm like, oh, maybe this is the week I blend a little bit more normal gameplay in. Only to the 21, okay. Alright, we have to stop Russ. I don't know how we're going to do that, but we're going to have to.
possession of the second half. And this game was all square at halftime, but now they find themselves down 7 following the opening.
Okay, only game 3 there. That's fine.
They need to take a good relaxing deep breath, don't you think?
Because right okay.
Now, they might start to feel like they've got to play catch up here and start matching them point.
This guy's going to probably cut in.
There. They can still run their offense. Plenty of time to get back in this.
Oh my god, dude. I fucking told him to go for it and he just ran right past him. Didn't even try to make a tackle or anything. What the fuck? Literally holding to fucking die, make an interception, do something. I read that so perfectly and nothing.
There's Wilson to throw. Open man left side, it's a tight end, man hurts.
That was the play that was going to change this whole drive. And now it's completely, they're just driving. And it's not good.
There's Wilson. He's across midfield, and he'll take this down.
They're just picking up first, left and right. This is not good.
Well,
we have the lead, so bend, don't break, I guess, but that's not exactly what I want.
On first down, Wilson.
Yeah, throw away. Okay.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really
do we blitz?
Has been all
you know, I'm going to go nickel. We're going to try to blitz. And yeah.
The NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against.
My god, he fucking stiffed on me into oblivion.
To the end of this third quarter play. Back now at Ford Field. It's the Broncos trailing, but they do have possession of the football as we begin.
Okay, I'm going to predict they run this way, and I'm going to double up.
They'll try to run for it. Here's
there we go. Nice.
They'll lose yardage back at the 38. They lost a big chunk, 6 yards.
Okay, so, oh, they have to punt. Damn. Okay, that was just the right amount. And he kicks it out at the 21. That is not a good punt. So at this point, we just run and try to hopefully pick up some more scores. More points. More scores. Oh my god. I can't talk. But like, we pick up any point, any score, whether it's a field goal or a touchdown. We create a two-score lead. I can't even talk right now. Because I'm amazed we are still in this game. That looked like a face mask. But I guess not, because they didn't call it. But, yeah, no. Just get into field goal range. Drain the clock. Oh, this is not good. Yeah, we only gained a yard there. Well, we do have a route with Gibbs here that might happen. Let's see what happens here. Dude, under pressure. Dude's nowhere near my quarterback yet, and he fucking... Yeah, Fields is not the answer, and he is gone. I'm actually half tempted to just see how Hendon Hooker would do by putting him in. You know what? We are. We're bringing Hendon Hooker in. See how he does. Because, I don't know. I have a feeling Hendon Hooker is more of, you know, if you're going to hit me, just fucking hit me. Like, I have a feeling he'll give a, not give a care by Fields. It's kind of like, please don't touch me. Oh my god, dude. That was the toughest fucking battle. I thought we were in there and broke it up. Second inches, they're going to... Oh, I'm going to blitz. I don't know how much I like this, actually. Oh, big sack, loses yardage. Fortunately, we're not getting the man we need to get the dev increase. Do I put him in for these final plays, see if I can't get a tackle for loss or a sack with him? That sounds stupid, right? But... And 4th and 5, we actually stop him. Okay, hold on. We're going to go depth chart here. See where he's at. He should be defense. Wait, where is he? Is he a linebacker? I'm sorry, am I missing him somewhere? Okay, I think I may have just completely forgot who I'm supposed to get. Wait, is there a way to check? No, there isn't. I totally forgot who I'm supposed to get the tackle for loss with. I remembered earlier, and then I got messed up getting mad at the game, and now I can't remember. Shit. Okay, so 38, that's not bad. I don't know. Can't remember, man. This is rough. This is really rough. Alright, pick up three. That's fine. Let's drain the clock a little bit. We do need to try to get into field goal range. Okay, pick up three there. We need more than three this time, though. Oh, they are so not falling for this. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
And now the first throw for the backup quarterback, buying time to his left.
Okay, well, we brought in Hendon Hooker, and it works out just fine. Is Hendon Hooker just our quarterback of the future? Like. I was hoping I'd just rush over that guy, and that did not happen, man. This run's not going to go anywhere. He's having a big game running the football, but that will hurt the yards per carry a little bit. Yeah, but the average he's got so far, that's the type of average he wants to take with him to contract negotiations. Okay, third and three. And he'll be taken down right around the 41-yard line. No. Do we just try here? This is third and three. Yes, we do, because we pick up the first. And we're going to take it down to under the two-minute warning. And we'll just let it tick down to the two-minute warning where we still have a touchdown lead. This is an ugly game. The fact I can't remember what player needed a tackle for loss is ugly. Oh, my God. I wish I would remember who. All right, first and 10. Denver obviously has all three timeouts. We have a touchdown lead. That zone, that hole closed up. I was hoping to hit it. Okay, so they burned their first. That's fine. So get a first win. There we go. And we're definitely in field goal range, so no matter what, unless some horrible atrocity happens, we should have this. Oh boy, I'm just so afraid something might happen, though. You know, Jahmyr Gibbs gets in, touchdown. There we go. And so this should, thankfully, cover it, but we still have, you know, minute 45. Weirder things have happened in the NFL. You know, a quick touchdown gets it. He should kneel. He doesn't. Okay, so they're out at 22, minute 43 left. Here comes Russell Wilson. And back it up. Back it up. Gonna do what we did last game. Back it up. We have the lead. It's been a struggle to score all day, and now they need to do it twice here late to have a chance. Oh, I thought Walker could get there. Oh, it actually is incomplete. Oh, nice. I thought he caught that. When you're leading in the final quarter, your radar has to be up for any potential deep shots. And probably not.
not the last one they're going to see in this game, not as long as they hold this lead.
Why are they talking about deep shots? That wasn't a deep shot.
Wilson. And that's caught by Williams.
Okay, third and one, that's fine. Because they are wasting time. Oh, Sutton smacked it away. Fourth and one. I mean, they're going to have to go for it. Okay. They're going to run out on this side, so I'm going to double up on this side. No, I guess not. Okay, you picked up your first, but at the cost of a lot of time. Shit. Oh, what a sack by Anzalone. We're going to go cover two invert. Okay. This is really kind of it. Yeah, I'm just going to step over to Barnes. He throws away 7 seconds. Yeah, game's pretty much over. But this now just goes three deep. Really, you're not going to give me the three deep? I guess we'll just do the cover three seam. Got three deep anyways, so it works, but... Another sack. Oh, no. Wow. And so we can just kneel it, and, yeah. There we go. We win another one. It's ugly. It's not pretty. But I guess that's the way I play football. Just like me, it ain't pretty, but it's working. 21-7. We didn't score until the end of the second, and I think the end of the third, and near the end of the fourth, funny enough. I doubt we complete it. Anzalone has one. That makes sense. We'll just go pass coverage because he does need that help. Rareness 2, zone 2, 1 play wreck. So zone goes up to 70. That's a pretty crucial point. Like, and then it was play rec that went up by 1. So that's out of 77, but it's down 1. So technically it's out of 78. Rareness is playing up to an 82. It's an 81. And so here we go. We probably didn't get it because I couldn't remember his name. Oh, McNeil did get it. He's a star player now. Okay. I didn't even remember his name. But here we go to week 16 against the Minnesota Vikings, who were 7-7. We're second place. They're 8-6. We beat them. We tie. Then we have to go to Dallas, and then we play the Vikings. If we beat the Vikings both times, we technically will take the NFC North. How, with how bad the series has gone, are we still in for the NFC North? Oh, boy. And I mean, the Green Bay Packers are still in it. Gotta love the Packers, and the Bears are doing better than they are IRL. So, yeah, a lot of stuff going on, guys. I will take care of the... franchise staff upgrades. I want to thank you guys so much for watching. And till next time, tag out. A special thank you to all my Patreon supporters, Urza. And if you're interested in supporting the channel, wanting to see content early, or just to make me re-record this because I'd have to add another name to the list, check out Patreon and link description below.